Hello students, how are you all doing? This is Mr. Kenneth Miranda, your social science teacher. Students, before I begin with my session today, I would like to ask you whether all of you are watching channels like Discovery, National Geography, Animal Planet, etc. If not, please do so, as these channels help to widen your knowledge about what is being taught by me. It would also help you understand the topics being taught in a much better way. Students, earlier I had uploaded the video of lesson 3, Northern Plains, in which I talked about the Ganga Basin. Hope you all enjoyed and learned a lot. Today, I am going to continue and tell you about the remaining two basins, which are the Brahmaputra Basin and the Satluj Basin. And also, I'll be talking about the importance of these basins. In the previous session, we studied about the location of the Northern Plains. In your previous videos, you just saw how the Northern Plains spread from northwest to northeast parts of India, from Punjab to the Assam in the east, northeast. Now, we talked about perennial rivers. Did you find out what is the meaning of perennial? I wanted to let you find out what is the meaning of perennial. Perennial means those rivers which are found flowing throughout the year. They don't dry up. Some rivers which are flowing down from the mighty Himalayas like Ganga and Yamuna are fed by glaciers. Glaciers are rivers of ice, and that is why they don't dry up. They are perennial. Three major basins of Ganga, Brahmaputra and Satluj. Look at the map in the northeast. Look at Nepal, our neighboring states or countries of Nepal, Bhutan and Bangladesh. Look at this river. This is a huge river which originates from Tibet in China. It flows towards the east and then it enters Arunachal Pradesh here. And then it starts to take a U-turn. And then it flows to Assam and enters Bangladesh, where you can see it is meeting with River Ganga. And then both of them, they form a basin and which is known as the Ganga Brahmaputra Basin, forming a delta. You can see the triangle out there. There's a triangle formed out there, okay, which is known as a delta. You see how it flows for a long way, parallel to the Himalayas, enters into India, then into Bangladesh, and then falls into the Bay of Bengal. Let's talk about the Brahmaputra Basin. The river Brahmaputra starts in Tibet. It flows eastwards and enters India in Arunachal Pradesh. Then it flows westwards towards Assam before entering Bangladesh. It receives heavy rainfall during the monsoons. As the monsoon winds begin from the eastern parts of India, most of the rainfall is received by this region. Heavy rainfall causes flooding in the river and the surrounding areas. the fertile soil. Wherever there is a river and it is a permanent river, perennial river, then a lot of fertile soil is available in this region. And this region grows a lot of crops like jute and rice. Now we move on to the next basin, and that is the Satluj basin. As you can see, the dark blue, the bold blue color, you can see, is the river Satluj. And the river Satluj also originates from Tibet, okay, and moves towards the west. And it is one of the tributaries of river Indus, the major river Indus. River Satluj originates or begins from Tibet. It flows through Punjab and Haryana. As this region does not get much rainfall, dams like the famous Bhakra Nangal Dam are built. These dams provide water and electricity for irrigation. Irrigation is a very, very important topic, and we'll be discussing this in the later parts of the subject. The Indira Gandhi Canal, which starts from Satluj, provides water to dry areas of Rajasthan. Since lots and lots of rivers are flowing from there, some of the canals bring water to the dry areas, okay, and these areas have turned into greenery because of water from these rivers. The main crops grown in this region are rice, cotton, and sugarcane. These all crops need a lot of water. Rice and sugar, especially sugarcane, need a lot of water, as the land is very fertile because of the presence of many rivers. Lots of agriculture is done here. States of Punjab and Haryana grow a lot of wheat. I'll be showing you some pictures where you can see a lot of wheat is grown by the farmers. Huge fields. Some important cities in the region are Chandigarh, Jalandhar, Patiala, Ludhiana, Ambala, and the famous Amritsar. Do you know what is there in Amritsar? What is it famous for? Yes, you're right. It is the Golden Temple. Okay? Very. Most of you might have even been to the place. Alright. Importance of Northern Plains. The soil of these plains are very good for growing crops. These plains are not very cold, and thus people have lived here in large numbers since centuries. And because of this, the two states out there, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, are the most densely populated states of our country. Many of the famous and earliest cities like Patna, Kolkata, Varanasi, Delhi have grown on the banks of these rivers. Very, very important places like Varanasi, Haridwar lie in these regions, and they are very holy places because of the river Ganga flowing from these parts. And that is why many people believe living or residing near these or on the banks of these rivers. as the land is flat, we talked about plains. Plains means lowlands or flatlands. This land is flat. And because of it, a good network of roads and railways found here. Whenever there are flatlands, it is very, very easy to build roads and railways. Tougher on the mountains and plateau regions. Now, I wanted to show you the map of Punjab state, which also shows a river Satluj. Can you see? The river Satluj here. Okay, and another river Bias meeting river Satluj. Look at the important places out there: Ludhiana, Jalandhar, Firozpur. Look at the five rivers of river Indus, tributaries of river Indus. Look at the city of Lahore, Amritsar, very close to each other. Lahore is in Pakistan, Amritsar is in India. And Jalandhar, look at river Satluj here. Look at Bias. The other tributaries are Ravi, Chenab and Jhelum. This is what I was talking about. Lots and lots of wheat is grown here. Farmers are very rich, mostly. And they practice extensive agriculture in which they use very, very high technology. Like the combine harvesters are used to do all the work from reaping, sowing, harvesting. Everything is done by single machine. Look at it. Both the states of Punjab and Haryana are very, very rich in terms of agriculture. I wanted to show you the vast plains of Satluj. Look at the flatlands. Lot of greenery. Lots and lots of small streams, rivers you'll find there. Now, before I end, I wanted to discuss some of the important terms or definitions with you. First is range. Okay, have you heard of the word range? Mountain range? Yes, a row of mountains and hills is known as a range. I just talked about a glacier, the Gangotri Glacier, from which the river Ganga originates, and the Yamunotri Glacier, from which the river Yamuna originates. So what is a glacier? A large mass of ice that moves very slowly down a mountain valley. It is a mass of ice. It is accumulated out there with heavy snowfall. But when the temperature becomes a bit on the higher side or increases, then this river of ice starts to melt and then starts to flow down. Mountain pass, a road or way through mountains. Timber, wood that we use for building and making things. Resin, a sticky substance that is produced by some trees and used in making medicines, etc. Like a gum, it is very sticky. Now, perennial, I was talking about perennial earlier, a river that flows at all times of the year. When you go to river Ganga, you will never see. Any time of the year you will visit, you will not find it dry because it is being fed by the glaciers in the Himalayas. Basin. Now you might be wondering, what is a basin? You find a basin at home while you are brushing. Similarly, There is a flat land, large flat region, where small rivers join a large river. The whole of this place, this region, is a basin. The tributary you already know, a river or stream that flows into a larger river or lake. Lake River Ganga is the main river. River Son, Gandak, River Yamuna, Chambal are the tributaries of River Ganga. Delta, a piece of land shaped like a triangle I showed you earlier, where I showed you the Ganga and Brahmaputra Delta, where a river branches into small parts before entering a sea. Look at the wheat cultivation in Punjab and Haryana. A lot of wheat is grown there. Rich farmers in Punjab using latest technology in farming. Huge fields are there. It's very, very difficult for manual labor. So technology is used. These kind of machines are imported from US, Germany, other parts of the world. Look at the famous golden temple at Amritsar. Look at the golden temple. It's very, very famous. Once you visit Amritsar, you should visit this historic place. Another historic place, holy city of Haridwar. Very, very holy place. Look at the people out there, lakhs of people. In certain holy occasions, you will find a lot of people. Right. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll come up with the next lesson. So keep learning, enjoy yourself, stay safe. Thank you.